everyone, my name is Tianlein and today we talk about what are the benefits and costs of an ESO Plus membership in the Elder Scrolls Online. So let's get started with an overview of the ESO Plus benefits. You will get 10% more experience and crafting inspiration. Additionally, your trade research time are lowered by 10% too, and you get a 10% bonus on gold acquisition. Another small nice feature is that you can dye costumes too. Just approach a regular dye station and at the top right you can switch to the dye costume tab. Now you can dye hats and costumes to your wishes. If you like to decorate your house, you will benefit from ESO Plus too. It will double the allowed furnishings and collectibles in your home. Then you get access to all DLCs in the Elder Scrolls Online. This means at the moment you can access 5 DLCs. The Imperial City is in Cyrodiil and also a PvP area. Additionally, you have a PvE questline and you can do some daily repeatable quests. Then you can challenge yourself in 2 group dungeons, the White Gold Tower and the Imperial City Prison. With the Orsinium DLC, you will receive a beautiful big zone to explore and many hours of content and quests. Also, you get access to 7 dailies and 2 large public dungeons, Old Orsinium and Rekindleft. If you need an extra challenge, you can try the Maelstrom Arena. The Thief's Guild DLC will give you access to the Zone New Spain, the Thief's Guild skill line and story content related to the Thief's Guild. You can accept daily heist missions and take part in other criminal activities. Then you get access to the Maw of Lokai trial. The Dark Brotherhood DLC will give you access to the Gold Coast. Experience the Dark Brotherhood story, get a new skill line and enjoy multiple daily repeatable quests. With the Shadow of the Hiss DLC, you will get 2 new group dungeons. The 2 Argonian-themed dungeons are the Ruins of Mazatun and the Cradle of Shadows dungeon. If you are interested in Morrowind, you have to purchase it separately. Morrowind is called a chapter and it is not included in ESO Plus. Then you get the awesome craft bag. This craft bag is a separate part of your inventory and lets you collect an unlimited amount of crafting and style materials. On your adventures, all materials you collect will get automatically and direct placed into your craft bag. If your ESO Plus membership expires, you will still be able to access your resources in your craft bag, but you are not able to add new materials to it. With the arrival of Morrowind in June, ESO Plus gets additionally double bank space. That means your bank will grow from 240 to a maximum of 480 bank space slots. Furthermore, you get crowns which you can spend in the in-game store. How much crowns you get depends on your purchased ESO Plus time. You will get the complete crowns delivered at the time you purchased ESO Plus. Now I will show you how much ESO Plus costs and how much crowns you will get. For PC, Xbox and PS4, 1 month of ESO Plus costs $14.99 and you will get 1500 crowns. For PC and PS4, you can purchase 3 and 6 month subscription too. If you buy a 3 month subscription, you will get 4500 crowns and it costs you around $42. That means you pay $13.99 per month. If you purchase the 6 month subscription, you will get 9000 crowns and it costs around $78. That means you pay $12.99 per month. Keep in mind that your subscription will auto-renew itself if you do not cancel it. Personally, I am an ESO Plus subscriber. My main reason for the subscription is the craft bag, and I am looking forward to the increased bank space. I don't want to miss this feature since it was really hard with the limited storage space. If you are enjoying decorating your own houses in Tamriel, I think the doubled furnishing and collectible limit is a great addition too. When you are not sure what DLC you should purchase, you could maybe buy 1 month of ESO Plus and use this time to take a look into all DLC areas. So you can test out every DLC and see which one you like the most. My favorite DLC is the Orsinium DLC. I really enjoyed to explore and experience this huge new zone and story. What is your opinion about ESO Plus? Which of the DLCs are your favorite? And which benefits of ESO Plus do you like the most? Thanks for watching and hopefully you enjoyed my overview about the benefits and costs of ESO Plus in the Elder Scrolls Online. It would be great if you subscribe, like or leave a comment Have a good day and until next time. Tschüss!